Okay, so as I was saying, good morning to all. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Miguel Herrera, and I work for OPAGAC as deputy manager. OPAGAC is a producers organization, a European producers organization that represents the interests of large tuna purseines in Spain and other countries as well. We have 9 members, those include companies in Spain and in other countries. We represent the interests of 51 purseiners, which are registered to operate in tropical and subtropical waters of the 3 oceans. The catch from the fleet is representing more or less 8% of the global catches of tropical tunas in the world. And from those 51, 18 vessels are operating in the iccat convention area and target tropical tunas, especially in the waters in the eastern tropical and subtropical areas. Since the formation of OPAGAC, we have been very much involved in the work of iccat and other fisheries management organizations, because they share the objectives of achieving long-term exploitation of the stocks and their purview with the least negative environmental impacts. Both of these objectives are key to the sustainability of our fishing, tuna stocks and market supply. While I will be talking about the activities of OPAGAC in relation to the tagging project, to iccat's tagging project, I believe that the level of involvement of other European purseine associations has been the same to this project, so I guess that my talk can be extended to the other associations, Ortongel and Anabac as well. OPAGAC has been actively involved in the work of AOTTP through participation to the design and implementation phases of the project. We have been in touch with the iccat secretariat and the AOTTP field officers to assist with the recovery of tags from the purseine fleet, from our vessels, sending communications to our vessels to request cooperation with the project and facilitate the collection of tag tunas. In addition to this, OPAGAC has agreed to the release of purseine and logbook and world map data, so fine scale information, to assist in the identification of fishing time and areas for recovered tag tunas. This is a very important information for the project. Overall, the purseine fleet has been the major contributor in terms of the number of tags recovered. I guess we will see some of these results later during the week. And in addition to this, we have also facilitated implementation of tag seeding experiments through assistance to onboard observers for the tagging of captured fish prior to storage in the wells. This is very important information to adjust the tag reporting rates for the fleets. We are really pleased to see that the project has achieved many of its objectives, and we look forward to the future use of tagging data on the assessments of tropical tuna stocks. We believe that the assistance that we have provided and that has been also provided by other associations will help in the estimation of key inputs to stock assessments of tropical tunas, including age and growth, exploitation rates, natural mortality, tuna movements and other. And we are very pleased to see some of these results presented at this workshop. On the other side, we have to say also that we regret a bit that as the experience is telling us from other tagging initiatives, the estimation of reporting rates for non-purseine fisheries seem to be low or difficult to estimate. It's a difficult matter. Either the tag seeding experiments are not possible, or reporting of tags from those fleets is very low. So this complicates a bit the usage of the data for stock assessments. This then may compromise the estimation of exploitation rates for those fisheries. And a very important thing for us, the the level of interaction between poor seine and other fisheries. We consider very important to address this because there is some claims right now on the table that that interaction is harming some fisheries. While the AOTTP was very successful in covering a large area of the Atlantic, we believe that those efforts could be undermined by low reporting rates in areas where poor seiners did not operate and jeopardized estimation of movement rates of tunas. Also, some other information that is very important for the assessments. So we really look forward to recommendations from the workshop to address these problems and for that to be addressed in the future. While we acknowledge the importance of tagging data as well, the experience from other oceans, such as the Indian Ocean, tell us that using such data for stock assessments requires a significant amount of time, as data must be thoroughly reviewed and analyzed. Therefore, we kindly request caution in the use of information derived from tagging for stock assessments of tropical tunas. But when I am talking about experiences, I am referring to the Indian Ocean, to the IOTC, where information from tagging has been on and off on the assessments due to problems that have been identified with the use of the information for some of the assessments. So this is a long process and requires quite a lot of time to be able to use the data properly. Finally, I would like to reiterate our commitment to continue assisting the AOTTP within our capacity to ensure that the project can make the most of the tax recovered. The OPAC Act fishery is currently being evaluated against the standards of the Marine Stewardship Council, which is a sign that achieving the best science and sustainable stocks is in our own interest. We hope that the work of the IOTTP will assist iccat in the process of adoption of management procedures for stocks of tropical tunas, and are happy to maintain our commitment to such task. Thank you to you for your attention, and in particular to the organizers for inviting us to provide this talk. Thanks a lot.